What's good, everyone? This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Today we're going to be talking about how to add radicals. And I'm going to show you guys three very helpful tips. So let's get started for today. So the most important thing that we need to know about these radicals is they have to have the same root, all right? Which is also known as the index. And I'm going to show you what that is. So if you look at our first problem here, we cannot add these two radicals because they have different roots, right? Also known as the index. When you don't see a number in the index, like with radical 72, we should know and understand that the index is 2, right? Square root, so the index is 2. So we can't add these. But let's say we do have radicals with the same root. So let's say we had something like this. We had radical 50 plus radical 18 plus radical 10. And in our previous video of how to simplify radicals, remember, we're going to try to break all these radicals down using the largest perfect square, right? We're dividing. So when I look at 50, I think we could use 25 and 2, right? Radical 25 times radical 2 will give us radical 50, right? And once we look at this, we know that 25 is a perfect square. So once we simplify, we'll get 5 radical 2, right? Now let's go on to our second radical. In the second radical, right, we could, I know 6 times 3 goes into 18, but none of those numbers are perfect squares, right? So let's try a different combination. Let's say we did 9 times 2, right? Radical 9 times radical 2. And when I'm looking at these two radicals here, I notice something. We have a perfect square. So we're going to simplify our perfect square, and this is going to turn into 3 radical 2, right? Because the square root of 9 is 3. All right, so now we go over to the last radical, which is 10. And the only thing or the only factors that we have are 1 times 10 and 2 times 5. So there are no perfect squares that go into 10. So what we're going to do is we're just going to bring it straight down because it's not going to change. We cannot simplify that radical anymore, right? And now at this step, guys, we simplified all our radicals. Now we need to find radicals with the same radicand. And all that's saying is we have to make sure that they have the same number under the radical symbol. Once they do, we could add them by just adding the coefficients and keeping the radical the same. So in this problem here, we're only going to add 5 and 3. Think about it as combining the total amount of radical 2s that you have. So we add 5 radical 2 plus 3 radical 2. That will give us 8 radical 2. And because that last radical, it's a different number under it, we cannot add it to 8 radical 2. We'll just bring it down and it'll be a part of our answer, but we cannot actually combine these two. All right? So let's say we have a radical now where there's coefficients in front of the radical. So there's numbers in front of the radical. How would we go about solving? So let's say we had a problem like this, right? We had 12 radical 7, and we're going to add 5 radical 63. So the first thing we should notice is the numbers under the radical are not the same. And when I'm looking at 7, we can't break 7 down anymore, right? So we're probably just going to leave 12 radical 7 alone, and let's focus on radical 63. Now, in my mind, I'm automatically thinking 9 times 7. So let's try that one out, right? So we have 5 times radical 9 times radical 7, right? Broke this radical down. And at this step, we're going to notice that We have that perfect square that we're looking for, and now we need to simplify. So once we simplify, we're going to have 5 times 3 times radical 7. And once we finish up this problem now, simplifying this part of the problem, we'll have 15 radical 7. So we simplified 5 radical 63. Let's go back now and let's actually see if we could add these two radicals. So when I bring down my other radical, because we could not simplify it, I've noticed that we do, and let's just make our addition sign black so it sticks out. I noticed that we do have the same numbers under the radical, right? So what I'm gonna do now, we're just gonna add our coefficients, the numbers in front of the radical, and then we'll be done with the problem. So when we're looking here, to finish this up, we'll have 27 radical 7 as a final answer.